Step 2 Christ, Chapter 11, The Privilege of Prayer. Through nature and revelation, through His providence, and by the influence of His Spirit, God speaks to us. But these are not enough. We need also to pour out our hearts to Him. In order to have spiritual life and energy, we must have actual intercourse with our Heavenly Father. Our minds may be drawn out toward Him, we may meditate upon His works, His mercies, His blessings, but this is not, in the fullest sense, communing with Him. In order to commune with God, we must have something to say to Him concerning our actual life. Prayer is the opening of the heart to God as to a friend. Not that it is necessary in order to make known to God what we are, but in order to enable us to receive Him. Prayer does not bring God down to us, but brings us up to Him. When Jesus was upon the earth, He taught His disciples how to pray. He directed them to present their daily needs before God and to cast all their care upon Him. And the assurance He gave them that their petition should be heard is assurance also to us. Jesus Himself, while He dwelt among men, was often in prayer. Our Savior identified Himself with our needs and weakness in that He became a suppliant, a petitioner, seeking from His Father fresh supplies of strength that He might come forth braced for duty and trial. He is our example in all things. He is our brother in our infirmities, in all points tempted like as we are, but as the sinless one His nature recoiled from evil, He endured struggles and torture of soul in a world of sin. His humanity made prayer a necessity and a privilege. He found comfort and joy in communion with His Father. And if the Savior of men, the Son of God, felt the need of prayer, how much more should feeble, sinful mortals feel the necessity of fervent, constant prayer? Step 2 Christ, page 93.